Hello grade 8. Today's topic is bearings. What is bearings? Today we are going to study, okay? What is bearing? A bearing describes the direction of one object from another. From some place to another place, okay? Some object to another object. Like that we are going to measure how much angle it is, okay? So three important features of bearings are: they must be measured from north only. Okay, so from one object to another object, but we have to consider from the north. Okay, so must be measured from the north. Then they must be measured from clockwise. And the third one, they must contain three digits. Three digit means, for example, if more than 100 degree will be three digits. But what about the 90 degree, 80 degree, 70 degree and all? We should add a zero before 70, like that, okay? So it must be three digits means, for example, 70 degree, we have tried like 070 degree, like that, okay? Look at the examples here. The first one is, it's an acute angle, a point, the red line, okay? So the opposite to the arrow, that is the starting point. So from here, from north, we have to draw one vertical line, okay? So from N, from north to this starting point, we have to draw one vertical line. So from here, we have to measure this angle, okay? How many degrees it is? 60 degrees. How to keep your protractor, okay? So you have to keep your protractor from north, okay? So vertically, should keep it vertically. So when we measure, it's an acute angle, 60 degree, okay? How to write this bearing? 060, which means 60 degree, okay? So 60 degree, we have to write like this. 060 degree, it is 60 degree. Another one is, from north, okay? So opposite to this arrow is the starting point. So to the starting point, we have to draw one vertical line from north, which means the top, okay? So from top to the starting point, we have to draw one vertical line. From there, we have to measure this, okay? So how to measure this? This one from the north line, if it is continuous, it is 180 degree, okay, 180 degree, and the remaining acute angle, if you measure, it will be like 60 degree. So 60 plus 180 is 240 degree. It is already three digits, so we can write directly 240 degree, okay? And another one is from north, we have to measure it. So 180 plus something, it will make 330 degree, okay? Let's see how to measure this, okay? How to calculate the bearings, okay? So from A to B, to calculate the bearing from A to B, we have to keep your protractor over the north line, okay? So when you keep the protractor on the north line, the zero, the outer circle, zero will be on the top, okay? So when you measure, it will be 30 degree, okay? If it is B to A, if it is B to A, okay? Extend this line A to B, okay? It will be like 180 degree, and this remaining acute angle, you just measure from north, it is 30 degree. So it is 30 plus 180 is 210 degree, okay? Next, so how to keep this protractor? Find the bearing of B from A. B from A, so see how they kept the protractor. Look at this. See, so from it is on the north line, okay? the outer circle 0 is on the top. Okay, so you have to keep like this. So place your protractor over the north line with 0 degree at the top. Okay, what angle is this? It's a obtuse angle, so it should be more than 90 degree. So give the answers as a 3 figure bearing. It is more than 130, so it is in between 130 and 140, so 135 degree. Find the bearing of A from B. So from B to A, so it is more than 180 degree, because we have to keep our protractor from the, it's over the north line. Okay, so it should be more than 180. So place your protractor over the north line with 0 degree at the bottom, because we have to measure from B to A. Okay, so because you are measuring clockwise, you need to measure the exterior angle, right? Okay, so from north to north. Okay, north and clockwise means from right side to left side. Okay, like that. North clockwise. Clockwise, how the clock will move from the right to left. So we have to keep our protractor like this. Okay, so the exterior angle is how much? The angle has gone past 180 degree. It is more than 180 degree. So if more than 180 degree, we have to add it with 180. Okay, so it should be more than 180. Okay, and your homework is exercise 17.1 in your course book. Okay, take your course book. Exercise 17.1, question 1. Okay, there are some questions there. You have to use your protractor. Okay, and then find the bearings. Thank you.